إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كلام الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. فيا عباد الله، إن الله تعالى قد أمرنا بالإحسان إلى الجار، فقال تعالى: واعبدوا الله ولا تشركوا به شيئا، وبالوالدين إحسانا، وبذي القربى واليتامى والمساكين والجار ذي القربى والجار الجنب والصاحب بالجنب. So, slaves of Allah, indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded us to be good to our neighbors. And he said subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَعْبُدُ اللَّهِ, worship Allah and do not associate any partners with him. وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا, and be dutiful and good to your parents. وَبِذِي الْقُرْبَى, and likewise be good to your relatives. وَالْيَتَامَى, and the orphans. وَالْمَسَاكِينَ, and the poor and the needy. وَالْجَارِ ذِي الْقُرْبَى, and your neighbor who is your relative. وَالْجَارِ الْجُنُبِ, and likewise your neighbor who is next to you, who is close to you. وَالصَّاحِبِ بِالْجَنْبِ, and likewise your companions. قال العلامة السعدي رحمه الله في تفسيره: والجار ذي القربى, أي الجار القريب الذي له حقان. الإمام السعدي, he said in the tafsir of this ayah, explaining the statement of Allah, والجار ذي القربى, and be good to your neighbors who are your relatives. أي الجار, meaning your neighbor who is related to you, the one who has over you two rights, because your neighbor either has one of three rights upon you. Either he has all three rights, and they are the fact that he is a Muslim, so he has the right of Islam upon you. And likewise, he is a Muslim and he is your neighbor, so he has the right of Islam, and likewise the right of the fact that he is your neighbor. And thirdly, that he is related to you. So your neighbor has either one or all three of these rights. So the Shaykh, he said, Rahimullah ta'ala, وَالْجَارِ ذِي الْقُرْبَى, your neighbor who is your relative, the one who has over you two rights, the right of al-jiwar وَحَقُّ الْقَرَابَى, he has over you the right, and the fact that he is your neighbor, and the fact that he is your relative. فَلَهُ عَلَى جَارِهِ حَقٌ وَإِحْسَانٌ رَاجِعٌ إِلَى الْعُرْفِ, so he has the right over you, that you be good to him, and that you be kind to him in that which is known and custom, that which is known amongst the people. وَالْجَارِ الْجُنُبِ, and Allah said, your neighbor who is next to you, أَيَ الَّذِي لَيْسَ لَهُ قَرَابًا, meaning your neighbor who is not related to you. وَكُلَّمَا كَانَ الْجَارُ أَقْرَبُ بَابًا كَانَ أَكَدُ حَقًّا, and the more your neighbor is close to you in where he lives, then the more his right is upon you. فَيَنْبَغِي لِلْجَارِ أَنْ يَتَعَاهَدَ جَارَهُ, so it is upon the neighbor that he looks after his neighbors. بِالْهَدِيَّةِ, and giving them gifts. وَالصَّدَقَةِ, and giving them charity if they need it. والدعوه likewise inviting them over to your own home واللطافة بالأقوال والأفعال and being kind to them in speech and in action وعدم أذيته بقول أو فعل and not harming them with your speech or with your actions وقد أكثر جبريل عليه الصلاة والسلام من الوصية بالجار حتى ظن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أنه سيورثه and جبريل عليه السلام He would constantly advise the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in being good to his neighbors to the point where the Messenger thought and believed that the neighbor was going to inherit from him. فَقَدْ رَوَى الْبُخَارِيُّ وَمُسْلِمٌ عَنْ إِبْنِ عُمَرَ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُمَا أَنَّهُ قَالَ قَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ مَا زَالَ جِبْرِيلُ يُوصِينِي بِالْجَارِ حَتَّى ذَرَنْتُ أَنَّهُ سَيُورِثُهُ The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, Jibreel did not cease to advise me concerning the neighbor to the point where I thought that the neighbor would receive some of the inheritance. Meaning, من كثرة الوصية به ظن sallallahu alayhi wa sallam أنه سينزل عليه وحي من الله بأن يكون للجار نصيب من ميراث جاره. Due to the fact that Jibreel constantly advise the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with the neighbor and being good and kind to the neighbor. The Prophet believed that he was going to receive revelation from Allah that the neighbor would inherit from him. تأكيداً وبياناً لعظم مقام الجار وما له من حقوق. And this was to emphasize and to clarify the great status that the neighbor has over his neighbor and that which he has over him overrides. ولا يتم إيمان العبد حتى يأمن جاره and the iman of the slave will not be complete until his neighbor is safe from his harm. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم he said, as comes in Sahih Muslim from the Hadith of Abi Shuraih, that the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم he said, والله لا يؤمن والله لا يؤمن والله لا يؤمن. He does not believe. By Allah, he does not believe, the Messenger of Allah said 3 times. قِيلَ مَنْ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ They said, who, O Messenger of Allah? He said, الَّذِي لَا يَأْمَنُ جَارُهُ بَوَائِقَهُ He said, the one whose neighbor is not safe from his harm. And he also said, عليه الصلاة والسلام, لَا يَدْخُلُ الْجَنَّةَ مَنْ لَا يَأْمَنُ جَارَهُ بَوَائِقَهُ He will not enter paradise, the one whose neighbor is not safe from his harm. وعلق النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم الإيمان بالله واليوم الآخر بالإكرام والإحسان إلى الجار. And the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم he attached the belief of Allah and in the last day to being good and kind towards your neighbor. He said عليه الصلاة والسلام من كان يؤمن بالله واليوم الآخر فلا يؤذي جاره. He said صلى الله عليه وسلم He who believes in Allah and the last day, then do not let him harm his neighbor. And likewise he said, من كان يؤمن بالله واليوم الآخر فليحسن إلى جاره. Whoever believes in Allah and the last day, then let him be good to his neighbor. ومن كان يؤمن بالله واليوم الآخر فليكرم ضيفه. And whoever believes in Allah عز وجل and in the last day, then let him be kind to his guest. And let him honor his guest. وَمَنْ كَانَ يُؤْمِنُ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ فَلْيَقُلْ خَيْرًا أَوْ لِيَسْكُتْ And whoever believes in Allah and the last day, then let them speak good or remain silent. وَلَا يُمْكِنُ أَنْ يَكُونَ الْإِنسَانُ مُؤْمِنًا إِذَا بَاتَ شَبْعَانًا وَجَارُهُ جَائِعٌ قال عليه الصلاة والسلام ما آمن بي من بات شبعان وجاره جائع إلى جنبه وهو يعلم به. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم it is not possible for a person to be a believer whilst he is full in his house and his neighbor is next door and he is hungry. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم he said he has not believed in me the one who goes to sleep at night whilst he is full and his neighbor who is next to him is hungry and he is aware of his situation. وعن ابن عمر رضي الله عنهما قال سمعت النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول ابن عمر He said that I heard the messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم say, كم من جار متعلق بجاره يوم القيامة. How many neighbors will come on the day of judgment next to their neighbors, attached to their neighbors, saying, يقول يقول يا ربي هذا أغلق بابه دوني فمنع معروفه. And that neighbor will say, complaining to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, oh Allah, my neighbor closed his door on me and he stopped and he withheld his good from reaching me. So how many of us are not aware of what our neighbors are going through? And how many of us do not know the great status and the haq and the right that our neighbors have over us, whether they are believers and whether they are disbelievers? So it's upon the Muslim to act upon these ahadith of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. من أعظم أسباب دخول النار هو أن يؤذي جارك. From the greatest means and reason that a person enters the hellfire is that they harm their neighbor. فعن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال قيل للنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. أبو هريرة, he said that it was said to the messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم, يا رسول الله إن فلانة تقوم الليل وتصوم النهار وتفعل وتتصدق. It was said to the messenger, oh messenger of Allah, such and such a woman, she prays the night and she gives in and she prays the night and she fasts the day and she does actions of khayr and she gives charity. وتؤذي جيرانها بلسانها. But she also harms her neighbor by way of her tongue. فقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, the messenger of Allah said, لا خير فيها هي من أهل النار. He said, there is no good within her. She is from the people of the hellfire. فقالوا, and then they said to him, O Messenger of Allah, فلانة تصلي المكتوبة وتصدق بأثواب ولا تؤذي أحدا. It was said, O Messenger of Allah, and another woman who only prays her 5 daily prayers and she gives charity with little, but she does not harm anyone. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, هِيَ مِنْ أَهْلِ الْجَنَّةِ. She is from the people of paradise. وَإِنَّ الْإِهْدَاءَ إِلَى الْجِيرَانِ مِنْ أَحْسَنِ مَا يُوَرِّثُ الْمَحَبَّةَ وَيَنْزِعُ الضَّغَائِنَ وَيُقَوِّ الصِّلَةَ وَيَزِيدُ الْأُلْفَةَ وَالتَّرَاحُمُ. And indeed, from the greatest means of earning the love of your neighbor and making the ties and the bond between you guys stronger and placing mercy between each other is giving them gifts. Due to the statement of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, تَهَادُوا تَحَابُوا. Give gifts and you will love one another. وَقَدْ أَوْصَى عَلَيْهِ الصَّلَاةُ وَالسَّلَامُ بِبَذْلِ الْمَعْرُوفِ إِلَى الْجَارِ. And the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he advised us to do good to our neighbors. فَقَالَ أَبُو ذَرٍّ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ. Abu Dharr, he said, إن خليلي صلى الله عليه وسلم أوصاني أو إن خليلي صلى الله عليه وسلم أوصاني إذا طبخت مرقا فأكثر ماءه ثم انظر أهل بيت من جيرانك فأصبهم منها بمعروف. He said that my companion, my dear and beloved companion, meaning the messenger of Allah, advised me that if I was or our family were to cook soup, then to increase in its water and then to look to our neighbors and to give them from it. And Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu, he said, لا تحقرن امرأة مسلمة معروفا لجارتها ولو كان ثرس نشاه. Abu Hurairah, he said that the messenger said that a believing woman should not belittle any good that she gives to her neighbors, even if it be ثرس نشاه, even if it be a bone of a sheep that has a little bit of meat on it. وصح عن عبد الله بن عمر عن عبد الله عن عبد الله بن عمر بن العاص. It is authentically narrated that he said أنه ذبح شاة فقال, that he slaughtered a sheep and then he said أهديتم لجار اليهود؟ Have you given some of the sheep to my neighbor who is a Yahudi, who is a Jew? فإني سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. He said, I heard the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول, ما زال جبريل يوصيني بالجار حتى ظننت أنه سيورثه. He said, I heard him say, عليه الصلاة والسلام, that Jibreel did not cease to advise me concerning the neighbor until I thought that he would inherit from us. So, O slaves of Allah, let us act upon the nasa'ih, the advice given to us by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam, and let us be good to our neighbors, and do not let us harm them, whether they be Muslims, whether they be kuffar. We must be good to them and set an example for them. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه. أقوموا لصلاتكم يرحمكم الله.